As I mentioned, SNMP uses only a limited set of commands. These commands are get. This command retrieves specific information stored in a file. The actual command would be something like get 1.3.6.1.800.4.5.6. The translation of this is that the get says, I want something, and the number that it generates is similar to a file number. Each piece of MIB information is identified this way. Another command is get next. This is almost identical to the get command, except it does not want the current value of the identified file. It wants the next incremental value. For example, one file might show the current number of packets received by a port. This is returned in a get. A get next waits for the next update and returns that information. The next command is the get reply. Get reply is not so much a command as it is a reply to the get command. The get reply just returns the information requested in the get or get next command. Next is the set command. This is the command that allows you to configure the switch. It allows you to set a parameter in the switch's database. For example, if you want to change the IP address of the switch, you use the set command. And the final command is called an event or a trap command. While both terms are used, I like to call it a trap because that's actually what it does. The trap command allows you to configure the switch to send you a message based on a special condition occurring within the switch. In other words, when something happens that the network manager has defined with the trap, the switch sends him or her an alarm message. Now, this is important because typically the switch's SNMP client only replies to requests from the SNMP server. However, in the case of a trap, the switch generates a message to the server. For example, the client could send a message alerting the network manager of an error condition within the switch.